Are you looking for raw land or a building lot in Prince Edward Island, Canada? You've come to the right video. Continue watching. So essentially, a lot of people are now buying land in PEI. In the past, we've typically carried about 1,300 to 1,600 pieces of land. That supply has diminished by at least half. We're probably down to 800 or 900 pieces because people can't find homes, or they're too expensive, so they end up building something. Additionally, there's a lot of people talking about retiring here, primarily from Southern Ontario. So they're buying their land now, and then they're building on it later. Essentially, the process looks like this. In PEI, we have an MLS software package called Paragon. Paragon is what the agents and the brokers use. It can produce, by getting your name and an email address, something called a collab site. The collab site will allow us to set up a or many real-time searches, so if anything comes up that fits within your criteria for either land, apartments, commercial, residential, farms, you'll get emailed instantaneously if that's the way it's been set up, regardless of what agent or broker has listed that property. So essentially, the process starts at setting up your collab or your search. What we need to know there is what you're looking for. With land, it would be price, location, waterfront, non-waterfront, and size. Those typically would be the parameters. The more precise you become, the more filters you have or criteria, the less listings you're going to receive. And since there's only 900 and some odd land listings right now, you want to leave that search as open as possible. So send your agent that information and you'll start receiving listings. On to the next step. Everything in PEI, whether it's a house or land, commercial building, will typically most of the time have a PID or property ID number, which is indicated on the cut sheets and the owner's property tax bill in the top right-hand corner, usually followed by a dash 000. These PID numbers range from 3 digits to 8. At the time of this video, going by my memory, the smaller the PID number, the older it is. If it's 3 digits, that's an old PID number. If it's 8 digits, it's probably something new, maybe a new subdivision, condo, whatever the case may be. So the PID number is your key to the information world about that property. You can generate number one. I would take it to the government site that produces the satellite imagery. I refer to it as an ortho, but that's an old term. The map will produce an outline, property outlines, that you can generate GPS coordinates for. In past videos, I've told you, you know, don't look at these as absolute fact, but they're a good guideline. Always, always have a surveyor confirm where the property lines are if you intend to build or potentially buy. But for looking, this will get us to the property, because land does not have a civic address. So the GPS coordinates will get us not only to the property, but we can also use it to pinpoint where the survey markers probably are. If you wanted to take it a step further, you could use a metal detector to find the pins, assuming they're in the right place and haven't been moved. That gets us to the property. If you're looking on site, obviously you can drive there, fly over it, do whatever you want to do. If you're looking at property virtually, you can take it many steps further. The next step for me would probably be going to Google Earth, bringing up the road views. Google Earth only covers paved roads, unfortunately, here. So that will get you some views. The satellite Google imagery is great. And followed by Bing Maps. Microsoft's done a really great job with their satellite imagery for property, so I use that. We also have a system that is a pay for fee or fee-based system that the agents have. You can always request a geolink, and that will also give you registry information, the history of the property, how many times it's been transacted, if there's a mortgage, liens. And next would be the soil types. So if you're building on land, you probably want to know what the soil types are like or how much of that property you can use. You can find that out if it's not on that ortho or the government free website. You can usually go to the agricultural website, which is awesome because it shows you soil types. You don't have to become a soil type expert. You should get a pretty general idea of what's happening with that piece of land by going on the agricultural system and checking it out there. Ultimately, at the end of the day, the person that's going to put the rubber stamp on the deal is the people at property at Access PEI. Access PEI basically covers all of our provincial services, from health to driver's license to land and building permits provincially. If it's a piece of land in town, Charlottetown, you probably want to talk to the city. Same with Summerside and other centers. So that will get you more information. They'll tell you what you can build. If it's waterfront, there'll be a setback from the water. If there's rivers, there's streams, there's a spring, there's typically a 60-foot environmental buffer around that. So you may not be able to build anywhere near that, and that can really mess a property up bad if you get a bunch of little streams and water sources on that property. Streams will also tell you where the land is lying low, and if your property you're purchasing is someone else's drainage ditch. So just start there. That's how it works. The collab emails are usually not sent to the agent. I mean, unless they wanted a lot of email. We've got over 1,000, 1,400 set up. So that would just go directly to you, so you're not going to get hounded. I did a video on the search. That's basically the criteria for it. Have a great day. Thanks for watching the video. Be sure to subscribe to the channel. Click on the little bell symbol and give this video a thumbs up, please. Bye for now.